If you enjoy using Google Home and Google Assistant devices and enjoy using the Google Assistant overall, but you're an iPhone user, you may or may not have realized that you have a problem with the iPhone if you want to use the Google Assistant on it hands-free. Well, what if I were to tell you that there was a way to do this that pretty much worked all the time? Let's dive in. Earlier last year, Apple released iOS 12, and in iOS 12, there's a feature called Siri Shortcuts. Siri Shortcuts are just shortcuts that allow you to do different pieces of automation on an iPhone. Now, up until recently, the Google Assistant had nothing to do with Siri Shortcuts, but that all changed a few months ago when Google made an update to the Google Assistant app on the iPhone that allows you to create a Siri Shortcut. And I'm gonna go ahead.
Let us conjure up new time-saving tricks together. And you get to pick the magic words. You can get all the details on apple.com.
There you go. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to set up a Siri shortcut. But before I do, you're gonna wanna make sure you have two apps downloaded on your phone. The first one is the Google Assistant app. If you're a fan of the Google Assistant, you should just download the Assistant app anyways. It's awesome. It just shows you a lot of nice visuals, and Google's material design is just, it's really nice on the app. The second app you're going to want to download, if you don't already have it, is Shortcuts. And you can download that from the App Store. So, assuming that we have both of those apps downloaded, let's go ahead and swipe down in the middle of our screen, and there's Shortcuts right there. We're gonna bring up the Shortcuts library. So the first thing you're going to want to do is click Create a Shortcut. Next, in the search bar, type in the trigger phrase for the Google Assistant. I'm not gonna say it because I don't want to trigger your Google Assistant at home. All right, after you've selected that, go ahead and hit the play button just to make sure it works and it's triggering the Google Assistant on your phone. And as long as it does that, we can go back to Shortcuts. If it doesn't for some reason, try it again, and also make sure that you have the Google Assistant app downloaded on your iPhone. All right, so after selecting the trigger word for the Assistant, if you click done, you're not actually done because notice it says untitled shortcut. So what we need to do is we need to click the three dots, go back into the shortcut, click the sliders at the top right. Let's go ahead and name this. We're gonna name this shortcut Get Google, because that's what we want Siri to do. We want Siri to get Google for us. And the Siri phrase is going to be Get Google. I've already set the shortcut up once, so it already knows my voice, but I'm gonna go ahead and re-record it. Get Google. All right, now that we've recorded our phrase, we can click Done. You will need to click Add to Siri. Right now you can see my Siri phrase is selected. If you see text that says Add to Siri, go ahead and click that to make sure that Siri is aware of this shortcut. After you've done that, go ahead and click Done. Click done again. Now for the moment of truth, click your home button, or if you're on a newer iPhone, swipe back up to the home screen, and then go ahead and say, hey Siri, get Google.
Running your shortcut. Done.
And there you can see the Google Assistant is now running hands-free on an iPhone. So what can you do with this? Well, there's a lot you can do with this. Let's say you're shopping in a grocery store, you've got your hands full, and you just need to see your shopping list. Well, all you have to do is say, hey Siri, get Google.
Running your shortcut. Okay.
Show me my shopping list.
Here you go.
And there you go. There's your shopping list. So there's some pretty useful things that you can do in your car or if you're out and about and shopping. And that's how you do Siri shortcuts with the Google Assistant. If you like this video, please be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this one. And there are some videos that we've just put out. We just put out a video on Google Home features updates, as well as what Google announced out at CES last week. So definitely be sure to check that video out. Well, thanks again for watching. I'm Josh Tedder for 6 Months Later.